Still the RTTV Breakfast Show, and just before you tune in, I was having a chit-chat with Musti Lala. Now, you must have heard me hail his name on Men's Team of a number of shows, a number of times, and it's great to have him in the house. He's a friend of the house. It's great to have you the show. Hottie, by the way. Hottie. I was just talking about, yes, I know you came in from Niger State. How was your journey getting to Lagos? How was it?
Yeah, well, the road are getting better, so it's a lot better now.
Okay.
But to be before, those roads are bad, so...
How long did you spend?
Like 10, 11 hours.
Wow. Just sitting down. Man, that's something. It's been a while I spent that long on the road anyways, by the way. Great to have you. Great to have you on the
show. Thank you.
Come on. I actually didn't know. I would have thought, if someone had told me that, oh, Musti is a wonderful artist and he sings, I wouldn't have thought about it. When did you start music and how did you get into the whole music thing?
Yeah, the music thing, I started long before now, like 10, 12 years ago. Yeah, when I was in secondary school, I did sing a little bit, but my first studio work came up 2006.
Okay.
Then I was in the university, I was in under level then, so I tried some production.
Okay.
And some of my mates appreciated the work, and from there I just decided, okay, maybe I could do something better.
Wow.
But you know, music needs money, and in school, you know, parents are the one feeding me and all that stuff.
Exactly,
so there's no money, so I go low a little bit.
Okay.
So then later, some of my friends encouraged me to go back, and some of them even sponsored my production and all those stuff.
Man, and now those are friends who, those are the kind of friends you keep. Not the ones that will be coming to us and say, oh, bro, you cook today.
That's very teacher. So they really help, and after my graduation in 2011, so I went back to music fully.
Okay.
And, I was doing some other things, but I was more focused on the music thing. So,
how are you able to finance music now? Because yes, like you said, it's quite a lot.
Yeah.
Promoting and pushing music is not even. First of all, creating music is also money.
Yeah.
It's just a show. But then after creating, now you're talking about promoting it, pushing it, publicizing, DJs, clubs, and all of that. Have you been able to?
It has not been easy. That's the reality. But one way or the other, you know, for the fact that I have some other things that I'm doing.
Okay.
So I generate some funds from that side.
That's cool.
I'm not really depending on the music right now because the music has not started paying me. So it's like I'm the one paying the music.
For sure.
Is that my other work that I'm doing that is helping out?
Let's talk about passion. Definitely that means that you have a passion for the music.
Of course.
How would you advise somebody that has a passion, like you said, and the passion is not paying? Yep. How would someone like that go at the situation whereby I have a passion, let's say, for doing something, but then it can't be, it doesn't pay me at first. How do I go about it?
Yeah, what you do first is get another thing that will pay you, but don't leave your passion.
What if there's a clash? Have you ever come to a place whereby there's a clash?
Yeah.
You know, whereby now, okay, you're thinking that, let's say it's a 9-to-5 job, and then you come back very late, and then you work maybe Monday to Saturday.
Okay.
And then you don't have so much time. If you're a Christian, you go to church. If you're a Muslim, you go to mosque on Friday. And you don't have so much time to, you know, how in that kind of situation, but then this is the one bringing the money. What exactly should I do? And I don't want my passion to die, but then, man, my passion is not bringing the money.
No, you go with the money first. Hmm. Because without the money, you can't even do production. So you follow the money. The game that is paying you that money, you follow that game at that time.
At that particular point in time.
So when that game pays you money, then you go back to the music. Your own passion, whatever you do. So you go back there, and that's where you get the job done.
If music is paying now, you do music full-time?
Full-time.
Wow. How far are you willing to go?
Yeah.
Just let's speak your mind. Really, what is the most, how far are you willing to go for music?
Any length.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Any
because
length.
I love music.
Because you love music.
Yeah, any
length. Who are your musical icons, your musical inspirations? Let's talk about that, foreign and local.
Yeah. I don't do foreign much.
You don't do foreign much?
Yeah,
local. Basically
local,
okay, all right.
So, all this Wandeko, Olamide, Wizkid.
Okay.
I love all these guys, so
okay.
I try to see what they're doing, and that's where I've been going.
How's the reception been from your fans and from your friends?
Yeah.
Honest reviews.
School. You know, when I was in school, the love was there.
Was there. Like, you were performing in school, in concerts in school.
When there's any occasion, they had to call me.
Wow.
They even had to publicize my name, put it on posters and all this stuff.
Okay.
That was where I go way back in school.
Way back in school.
You know, now I'm just doing the music, promoting it on radio and all this stuff. So,
okay.
I don't know how much people love me, but on my Facebook page, okay. I have some likes.
You have some likes and all that.
Fans, that's cool. Love me though.
Okay, let's talk about your latest song now. What's it titled?
Elenium.
Elenium. What does that mean?
Someone with people. You, there are people around. Hmm. Our friends, our
I have
family.
Friends and family around. Yeah. Okay, so what was the inspiration behind the song? How was it putting that song
together? Yeah, it's just about the way things have been coming right from school, the way the struggle and everything.
Okay.
So I was just trying to explain. I feel like living my life like those that have big men around them. You understand? Okay. You know, in school, I only have this my guys that we all are struggling, but they try to help. You understand what I'm saying?
Wow.
Yeah, but what if they are the big people in the society?
In the society.
I won't be, you know, where I am right now. Maybe I'll be somewhere else. You know, that, you know what I'm saying? You know?
I get you.
So
I
that's the way it is.
That's way
so
it
I want to live my life like those that have those big guys. So if my home men now can't be the big guys, I'll be very happy. That's what I'm just trying to say.
Okay, now I just want to ask this off the books. What's your philosophy about life? What's your basic, and there's a reason why I'm asking this, what's your basic philosophy about life?
My own philosophy is just be happy.
Be happy.
Yeah.
Wow.
Whatever you do, make sure you're happy about it.
Wow.
Don't let anyone force you to do anything. Look, not even marriage. When you're not ready, don't do it.
So just
be happy. Whatever
I like that.
Makes you happy, that's what you should be doing. That's what I do, man.
Okay, now the reason why I asked that was because of a situation whereby now you've had people as friends who helped you along the line.
Yeah.
Now a number of people feel that human beings are fake.
Yeah.
That look, you cannot count on anybody to do it because of a past experience.
Okay.
You understand? How much should your experiences color your outlook on life? Should the person's experience? Because like you have a good experience with friends.
Yeah.
Some people have a very bad experience.
Of course.
And they just feel that look, man, people are not trustworthy.
Yeah.
So from that, now how much do you think that someone's experience should color the person's perception of life?
Mike, you see, when you judge someone by what others do to you, then you'll be very wrong. Because some people are bad.
While
you have some people that are extremely good. You understand? So if the good guys came and you're looking at them with the other guys that are bad, then you are doing something wrong.
Wow.
So for me,
until
you prove yourself to me, I don't judge you.
No matter what someone else said about that person.
I have to just know you. That's why I do my things.
That's wise.
Yeah, yeah.
You have to know somebody for someone, not just by what you heard from somebody.
Yeah.
Cool, great one. Now, Hotty. Now, how did the name come about, by the way?
Yeah, you know, the name came up in another level. We're doing this faculty, some occasion show.
Okay.
So they were giving an award. So we're in another level then. So I was giving Otis Jambite.
Jambito. Jambito. When people have
so
different names.
Otis Jambite. So from there, you know, Hottest, H-O-T-T-E-S-T, so the word. So my friends were just calling me Hottie.
Cool.
So the way I just keep the name
Hottie. You like it?
Yeah, of course.
It sticks.
I love the name.
All right, cool. Now let's see, how far do you expect the brand Hottie to go? Let's see, when you sit down and think about the next 3, 4, 5 years, what do you think about the brand Hottie, 10 years?
Yeah, in the next 3, 4 years, I'm seeing myself in a good record label, if I'm not holding one.
Good.
And I see myself being inspiration, a role model to others.
Other upcoming artists.
Yeah.
Now that's cool. Now, the content of your songs, about how many songs do you have out? How many singles do you have out?
Yeah, like 10 now.
Wow.
Yeah.
And did you have an album or EP out? Are you planning on soon?
You know, I don't just want to release an album that probably maybe few people be the one that noticed the album. I want to release the album when everyone will be in the market, like, where is Hottie album?
Cool.
And that's what I want.
That's what you want. Okay, so you want to, you know, you want to tease them, send, give them those singles so that by the time they ask for it, that you have something cool.
Then,
okay, now, over 10 songs and all that, what would you say is your major inspiration when you write? Do you write your songs?
Yeah, of course.
Okay, so what gives you the inspiration to write? Where do you catch it from the most?
Yeah, it depends on the mood at that time that I'm writing.
Okay.
You know, when I just feel like, okay, like when I wrote Elenium, what happened was, I remember those days in school, the struggle, everything, you know, when you had to wait for your friend to finish cooking before you heat, you know, and all those stuff.
You can say that again.
That was when
there was this group of friends, we only cook at early in the morning, 2-3 a.m. because we did not want some friends to come. We know that there's some food that if they come there, this food will be full also,
that's
man.
It, that's
it was fun. It was always
some people move around with spoons, Yeah, when you say you don't have spoon,
we don't know. I did use mobile. We had spoon everywhere. Anywhere you go, you have, you know, it is almost like you had somewhere hidden under your foam, under your pillow, in the classroom, the locker, in someone's cupboard. There was always something.
That's the 80s. So it's those things that I remember. So I just have to tell people that, look, I've struggled.
Wow.
I hustled.
Wow.
That's the way it is.
Wow. So just finally, as a final note, what should people expect from Hoti? What try to embody Hoti in a few words. What should people expect from the brand Hoti?
Great music.
Great music, okay.
And music that have message.
Wow.
When you listen to my song,
wow,
feel the chorus and the verse.
Wow.
I don't go outside the message.
Wow.
So always feel the message.
Wow, the message. Oh, God. Okay. Hoti is about to give us a message now. Thank you very much. How do we hit you up on social media?
Yeah. On Facebook, I am Hoti.
Okay.
On Twitter, at Hoti Official. H-O-T-T-Y.
Okay, H-O-T-T-Y.
Official.
Right. Official.
On Facebook, I am Hoti. I am H-O-T-T-Y.
Okay.
Then on Instagram, Mustyib. M-U-S-T-Y-H-I-P-P-E-D.
Yeah. We know we are. We are sure we are. We are H-O-T-T-Y. Hoti. Okay, so give us that message. Take us out.
Right.
When we get back, it's entertainment news and Magnifico has got you covered. All right, take us out, Hoti. Take us out.
Damn, I like that.
Fashion, yeah.